plant and went to other planets or galaxies.
Yes.
And he's another guy. He could do anything. So if he wants to beat Aquaman, he just rubs his lantern and he says, "Die, Aquaman," or whatever.
Okay.
What's the next one?
Stan, we are not talking about rubbing lanterns in this. We're not rubbing any lanterns here, okay? This is Aquaman. This is a guy who can communicate with sea life. He can breathe underwater. When he's in water, he's practically invincible. Aquaman. I mean, it's Aquaman. It's not, you know, he doesn't get his powers from some ring. He is his powers.
But if the two of them are about to fight.
Right.
Aquaman, first of all, the Green Lantern would be crazy to dive into the water. He'd rub his little whatever he rubs, and he'd bring Aquaman out of the water, and he'd have him float somewhere, and then he'd rub the thing again, and he'd kill him. And what? It's too easy.
Stan,
it's too basic.
We're not double rubbing. This isn't. All right, look, I'm trying to put up a good argument for Aquaman, but I'm going to have to agree with Stan and say Green Lantern will whip Aquaman, obviously. But I was trying for Aquaman.
Can we just assume that I will win all of them and then go on to a different
a safe assumption. He is trying to just take over the situation here.
Well, it's just somebody has to. You're just sitting there.
All right, fine. Green Lantern. Superman versus Green Arrow. So let me qualify this. Green Arrow is just a man who can shoot arrows, and his shot is impeccable. That being said, unless he has kryptonite arrows, he has no chance against Superman.
Oh, I didn't think of that. Oh, a kryptonite arrow.
A kryptonite arrow.
That's why you get the big bucks. Now, I would never have thought of that.
That's right, and he's probably the only person who could shoot an arrow and hit Superman who's dodging. Right?
Wow.
As fast as Superman is, Green Arrow can anticipate and all this other stuff. So if he has kryptonite arrows and he can can take a shot, he has a chance. But that doesn't change my final decision, which is Superman will whip his ass.
Even being hit with a kryptonite arrow?
You know, the chances that he's going to have any kryptonite. Kryptonite is, like, you know, more elusive to get than plutonium.
No, but we're just assuming. You were assuming he had a kryptonite arrow.
Well,
now you're going against your own opinion.
No. I was theorizing that if he had one, he'd have a chance.
Well, he could have one.
Yeah, well, but the thing is, there's a lot of people who have kryptonite and they still fail to beat Superman.
They don't have kryptonite arrows like Green Arrow.
Why are you being...
All of a sudden, I'm a big Green Arrow fan.
You're being difficult.
Yes, I tend to.
Okay, that's where we were going to agree here that Superman would win. That's what we were going to do.
I was going to say there's not even any contest. Of course Superman would win, but you cleverly, brilliantly came up with the idea of Green Arrow having a kryptonite arrow. That never occurred to me. Then Superman becomes Clark Kent, so to speak, and he can beat him. He can shoot another arrow at him and maybe kill him. I go with Green Arrow.
I go with Superman.
And I go with Green Arrow at a cut of you. How can you contradict me? All these years I've known you, you finally came up with a good idea, and you're walking away from it.
It was a theory.
All right. Aquaman's sitting there and he's pretending. He's like, "Oh, that boxing glove hurts." Mm. Then all of a sudden he's like, "Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo."
"I'm not pushing. I'm just, I've enjoyed..."
Are we really going to do this?
Yes, we're doing this.
Let me tell you something. Aquaman, it's a fish.